Alexa, stop. Good morning, guys. There's a lot to do today, but I'm looking forward to it. Another day in sunny California. Alexa, play Smile by Kirk Franklin.
I Smile by Kirk Franklin on Amazon Music.
I dedicate this song to recession, depression, and unemployment. This song to you.
Today's a new day.
As part of our New Year's resolution started early, we are drinking 16 ounces of water every morning to start the morning. Usually Kofi's the one who keeps me on track with this, but I just want to point out this beautiful water bottle that I have, a DITL gem water bottle. It's lovely. It actually has crystals and diamonds in the water to infuse the water with minerals. So I try to use that in the morning. I reviewed DITL for my blog Luxury Thesis, where I review luxury goods and experiences. So this is a beautiful gift that I received from them. And of course, Kofi doesn't want to feel left out. He wants to shout out his crystal geyser water bottle. Crystal geyser.
Minerals from the mountains of geyser.
It's too early for this.
All right, I just came to record one more time. I just realized I'm wearing this Chargers shirt in Mimi's video. I'm not a Chargers fan. I do some work with the NFL. They gave me the free shirt, but I have to give that disclaimer. Seahawks, baby. Go Hawks. Bye.
Don't be running up on my video. Okay, so, oh, look who it is. Look who it is. Good morning, Lincoln.
Good morning.
Oh, how did you sleep?
Good.
Good. Give me a kiss. Is Lai awake?
Yeah.
You guys need to get dressed for church, okay?
Okay.
All right, go tell her.
But first, they gotta
Some dads.
Okay, so I have a pretty busy Sunday today. We're gonna try to get to church early because after church, I have RSVP'd for an event, a women's panel discussion about a transformational vision for 2020. And then I have some things to follow up with regards to the foundation, a speaking engagement that I just committed to. I have a couple of errands to run. I think Lai is going to get her hair done today. It's going to be a pretty busy day, but hopefully a good day. So I'm just going to start my day with day planning, as I typically do. And it looks like I took out, oh, there we go. All right, so the only thing that's kind of missing in this planner is like a bookmark for what day. So I'm just kind of using a post-it note that I'm moving from day to day until I get to where I'm going. I need to fill this out, so Good morning. Good morning. Let's go for a walk. This is my treat. Patrick. Listen, Scotch. I don't mean to sound judgy, but I think it's time to take your Christmas tree down. Let's go. Tragically, I don't have time to make coffee this morning, but I'm just gonna see if I can grab a snack, like a granola bar or something, out of here. Score! So this is today's breakfast of champions. Last look. My family is already in the car waiting. Okay, good news is we are only 3 minutes late, so we made it. That was a miracle. Small miracle. Okay, so let me look up the address to where I'm going. Let's see. 35 minutes away. So I'm about 15 minutes late. Oh, joy. All right. Get that together. Let's drive safely. So we had a really good message at church today about prayer, how to pray. Praying is really important to me. I like that reminder. It's part of this sermon series that my pastor's doing called New Year, New You, or something like that. The bigger picture is he's just kind of going through different things we should consider to have transformational change in our lives that is sustainable. So that's kind of right on theme with what I'm going to today, which is a panel discussion with my good friend Pauline Malcolm that I met because she and I served on a board together for a nonprofit organization called Swan Within. I left the board and now Swan Within is one of the grantees for my sports foundation that I run. And yeah, Pauline's going to be on this board with, I think, also the actress Melinda Williams. So that should be nice. I'm interested to hear the perspectives, and I understand there'll be light fare and networking, so who knows what'll come out of it. All right. Let's see. Where am I going?
have to suck it up. Suck it up. Drive with a boulder.
All right, so I'm so excited about this, Pauline, that you've invited me to your beautiful event that you're having. Could you just talk a little bit more about it?
Sure, and firstly, thank you so much for coming.
Of course, I wouldn't miss it.
Love having amazing women like yourself here. So really, this event is one of many that I hope to have. It's I'm co-hosting with Melinda Williams, and I have a channel or Instagram 9to5Fab, and my event series is all about empowerment of women and bringing women together that are leaders in their respective fields. So this event is in spirit of that, but it's also speaking to women who of color that often have a superwoman complex. I myself have that. As I know you do, you know, high-powered women that have a career and a family and they're trying to juggle it and do it all and wear that cape. So we want to help women kind of dismantle that whole superwoman complex.
So I'm just so grateful. This is exciting, and I'm so blessed that we had a chance to serve on a board together, and that's how we met. And it's the beginning of a great friendship, and I will be there looking forward to the next event.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for coming.
Generational expectations of having to hold it down, having to fulfill financially, spiritually, physically, keeping your man down, keeping your man healthy. So all these things came sort of genuinely from mom, grandmother, aunt. And if you think about it, think about your history. Did you ever see any of them complain? They just did it. They just bossed up and they did it. So I think historically we're ingrained to be boss women with respect to being survivors, getting it done, handling it, being successful. But now that society has sort of a brand new bucket of expectations, we have to sort of look at this whole complex and figure out, what is that going to take? What is that am I going to leave behind? What's the blessing? What's the liability? And then move forward. And everybody's sort of bucket of what's the blessing and liability, everybody's recipe is going to look different. So we have to stop looking right and looking left and trying to emulate somebody else. Your walk, your recipe is your recipe from who? From him. And everybody's is not going to be the same. So I think recognizing that is what makes you have that sort of balance, right? That's that magic B word.
Okay, so I am just leaving the hotel, and that was such an awesome event. I'm so excited. I just feel so full having a conversation about dismantling the superwoman. But I think that it was kind of neat and constructive because it ended with this idea of, you know, what is Superwoman 2.0? What does a newly reimagined superwoman look like? What does that archetype look like? That's a healthy form of the superwoman archetype. And so I was just having a conversation towards the end and saying that I've kind of learned after trying to do it all unsuccessfully that what is a better process at this stage, like I don't resent having gone through a superwoman complex. I think that it has led me to be who I am today and to be where I am today. But now I see my role differently. Instead of having to do all the things, I see that Superwoman 2.0 is a woman who can leverage herself for the benefit of others at this stage. So that's really exciting to me. And the day is getting away from me. I understand that
Laya's, the hairdresser has already shown up at our house. So Laya should be getting her hair done. Luckily, I did get some flowers from the event. They asked us to take home the centerpiece flowers, so that's great because that was one of my errands I needed to do today. The next thing is just figuring out I want to get salmon maybe to make for dinner tonight. I still have a little follow-up work to do around this foundation stuff. I actually did the paperwork to deploy a grant through the foundation on Friday, because one of the little girls on my soccer team had a tragedy. The apartment complex where she and her father lived burned down. So they actually lost everything that they have, including all of her soccer equipment, which is, because it's club soccer, it's actually quite expensive to replace. I was just really feeling blessed that I was able to quickly draft a mini grant and submit it on their behalf and have those funds deployed so that within the next few days, she should be able to get the money so that she can replace all of her equipment for our upcoming State Cup soccer tournament, because that's something that I know that they need right now with all that they're going through. So I need to go home and follow up with that to make sure that that's good. And then I also received a request to speak at the Girls Academic Leadership Academy for International Women's Day, for a conference that they put on there. I was asked to be the keynote speaker, so I actually want to follow up with them to see if we can possibly coordinate some sort of media coverage for the event, because that'd be, I think, great all the way around. It's a wonderful program that they have going there. I think it'd be, you know, a good story for International Women's Day. So I need to go home and check those things out. I guess I'm gonna call right now and make sure that Kofi's surviving with those kids. So are we working hard or hardly working here? Watching a game.
Both.
And I'm really excited because I was able to check on the grant. I was just here doing some work, and it looks like the grant application is going to be completed in time to distribute those funds by Tuesday. So thank God for that. I'm so excited that I was able to help that family. I also convinced Kofi to leave football and actually go out and grab salmon for dinner tonight. So while I'm waiting for him to come back, I'm going to start lesson planning for homeschool next week. All right, let's just cheers that out.
There it is.
So I actually have already put garlic salt on the salmon, and I'm putting a heavy dose of smoked paprika. It smells so good. Dinner's gonna be so good. We had a great dinner together as a family because I was able to cook, which I don't always get to do. Then we put the kids to bed and I read for a little while I tried to read.